Answering this question might lead to the most common misconception about Git. But before I attempt to even answer that, we need to talk about two specific advantages that Git has over almost every other version control system. First off, how much better actually is Git than other solutions? I mean, just look at these numbers. 96% of professional developers use Git. And these aren't soft numbers either. They're from the 2022 Stack Overflow Developer Survey of over 73,000 software engineers. But why are these numbers so high? Well, it probably has something to do with Git's first big advantage, speed. If software projects are just folders full of code files, think of version control systems like sophisticated databases that do a variety of file management operations. In fact, with Git, most of these operations are near instantaneous. And speaking of time savings, what's the reason for that? Well, it comes down to Git's second and probably more important advantage, and that's how it handles collaboration. There are many types of version control systems. Some store that special database on a central server that all their collaborators must connect to in order to access the code. Others distribute copies of that database to each collaborator and then have protocols for syncing changes back and forth. Git is an example of this second type, also known as distributed version control. All right, but that's all pretty hand-wavy. And what's actually going on behind the scenes? Well, Git does something that's actually not so different than how you might have manually backed up projects in the past. Git stores snapshots of file history in a clever way that's actually pretty fascinating. But you'll find a whole library of videos covering that and other fundamental Git topics over my dedicated learning platform, learngit.io. So if you like this style of video or the other Git videos on my channel, LearnGit probably really gonna save you a bit of time and frustration. But I digress, because this is the part of the video where everything starts to come together. First, we have Git with its two distinct advantages, speed and its distributed architecture. And then over here, we have GitHub. And at last, we arrive at the million-dollar question. What's the difference? Well, remember that Git is a distributed version control system, which means engineers who are collaborating on a software project each have to have a copy of Git's database. Git then has protocols for syncing these databases together when changes are made. But here's the catch. If we have a lot of collaborators, every time one makes a change, each collaborator must import that change into their own Git database. And at scale, this can get pretty annoying. So instead of syncing with each other directly, why not host a single copy of the Git database in a central location and have each engineer sync with that? If we have that central copy, each collaborator can push the local changes there, and everybody else only needs to sync with that single repository to grab everybody else's changes. This is far more efficient than needing to contact each collaborator one by one to check if they have anything new. This is a far more scalable solution and works really well, but we do need somewhere to store that central copy. Well, that's where GitHub comes in. GitHub is an online platform that hosts copies of Git repositories, and it's by far the most popular online Git hosting platform. You just upload your repository and let GitHub do the hosting for you. However, the most common misconception is that you need GitHub to use Git. This is certainly not true. No matter how ubiquitous GitHub has become, core features like branching, commit history, release tags, synchronization features, those are all native to Git. You can even spin up your own dedicated cloud server and put a Git repository there to get the same benefits. So the next time you think about Git and GitHub, remember this difference. Git is a popular open source version control system, and GitHub is a for-profit company that hosts Git repositories. If you're interested in learning more, I have tons more Git videos on this channel and even more on learngit.io. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later. Bye.